Hello everyone. Today I, Dr. Japsi Malhotra from Amity Institute of Education, Amity University, Uttar Pradesh, is going to present my poster for topic Emerging Trends of ICT in Higher Education during COVID-19. We all know when the COVID-19 pandemic took hold in the whole world in early 2020, it profoundly disrupted nearly every facet of daily life. It includes education sector also. As educators made the hasty transition to online teaching, they made do with the tools and tactics they were given. Many teachers prepare their online courses. They must lay the groundwork for the long haul. As a growing number of countries are resorting to schools and university closures, there are some online tools those educators and students can use to teach and learn virtually. All teachers have got involved in many online communication platforms as Google Meet, Microsoft Teams, Zoom, etc. Their main goal is the continuity of spreading education to students. Various tools used for online courses transaction are there. Now, correct selection as per the content to be delivered has to be taken by the teacher. These days, teachers have to really work on many tools for making their lectures as effective as it was with the normal traditional routine of offline classes. The major concern is as follows. Not every subject transfer from well in person to online. Depending on the subject, your tutors, online tutoring may not be perfected. Until recently, it was almost impossible to stimulate the experience of free-form collaboration on a shared problem set online as it is common in maths and science tutoring. Then the next one is, forming an emotional connection can be challenging. When you begin teaching in a new student, there is a challenge in front of your mind that how to know about the student. So online platform is bringing that ice with the new student and can become challenging as it's more difficult to make an emotional connection without being present in the room. Holding the student's attention. As we know that the students are in the online mode, so when screens are open, there is no in-person supervision. There will be undoubtedly distracting windows also around open on your student's screen. So how to hold that student's attention is a big question. The good thing is that the problems like these can be solved in variety of ways by modifying your teaching approach to using new tools and software that help you get the job done. Most of the students are in their attention sake. Different various tools used for the course transactions I have divided them into four sections, as you all can see. First is video chat, Teams, Zoom, Skype, Google Hangouts, Microsoft, and the virtual whiteboards, Edro, Billboard, or the white, my MS Office can also be used. So 90% as per me, that we are using. Normally, teachers are using this for their higher education. Then are the assessment tools, Socrative, Google Form, Mentimeter, Kahoot, and many more are there. So this is the assessment tool which is used to check the attention of the students or to guide them whenever they are not following the right path. Next is screen recording, as I am using in this also, Camtasia, Powtoon, Animator, Screenocast-O-Matic, Salamations, VideoScribe, and the PPT can also be used. So 50% teachers are recording for the students so that they can be accessible whenever the network is available. Last I have divided into document collaborations. Teachers has to collaborate their thinking, collaborate their topics with the students. So Padlet, Mind Map, Google Doc, Dropbox, Microsoft Word has been used for that. So these are some of the tools which are used, the trends for collaboration, screen recording has developed in the online teaching. Thank you. Hopefully, I have jotted down all the points and you must like that. And thanks for listening to me. Have a nice day.